بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، إله العالمين، وبه نستعين، ونصلي ونسلم على خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأنت تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا. رب يسر ولا تعسر، وتمم بالخير، وبك نستعين. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for having gathered us here once again. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to surround us with the malaika and to cause His mercy and His sakinah to descend upon us and to raise us with the anbiya alayhimu salatu wassalam and those whom He has mentioned with them. Ameen. When it comes to the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then all of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are good regardless of what they are. And this comes from the ayah, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى, and belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the best of names. Al-Husna comes from Ahsan. It is the plural of Ahsan. And Ahsan means the best. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has only good names. They are the best of names. And He possesses no bad qualities and no bad names. فَدْعُوهُ بِهَا. So call out to Him using these names. So this is the reason why we learn these names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in order for us to understand how to worship Him and in order to use them to call out to Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. When it comes to the name Al-Khaliq, then Al-Khaliq has three stages. Al-Khaliqul Bari'ul Musawwir. The first stage being the stage of planning. The second stage being the stage of execution, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings into existence from nothing. And the last stage has to do with the fashioning of the creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala plans with all of His infinite wisdom and knowledge. And then He brings into existence that which He wants to bring into existence in the manner and in the shape that He wants to bring that particular creature into existence. So this is the meaning of Al-Khaliq, Al-Bari, Al-Musawwir. Al-Bari, meaning the one who brings into existence from non-existence. And Al-Musawwir, the one who fashions. Someone may ask, that how does all of this happen? How does all of this come about? When it comes to the how part of these qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then He subhanahu knows best. We don't understand exactly how this happens, because none of us really saw Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creating. But we know that He creates, because myself and yourselves are here today. We are proof of the quality of creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He wants to create, then innama amruhu idha arada shay'an an yaqula lahu kun fayakun. When He wants to do something, then the matter is only for Him to say kun, be, and it is. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about creation, then this is referring to the execution of that creation, the manner in which it was created. And this is why you find that when a human being plans, then sometimes he will plan something for 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, 20 years. He will plan to build a home. He will plan to start a business. But at times he will not execute that plan. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never fails to execute. Kun fayakun, be, and it is in existence. He fashioned us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this after mentioning our creation. And this is why He says, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَاكُمْ. And most definitely we created you. ثُمَّ صَوَّرْنَاكُمْ. Then we fashioned you. ثُمَّ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمْ. Then we told the malaika that prostrate to Adam عليه الصلاة والسلام. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this in the sequence. So khalq is different to bar, and bar is different to taswir, because he planned, he brought into existence from nothing, and then he fashioned. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates in this manner. When a person takes gods besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then what this person is doing in reality is taking a being that was created from some matter and making that the object of his worship. Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created from nothing, so he is deserved of that worship. At the time of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, when he had gone out and he went to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he went to speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then there was a man known as As-Samiri. And Samiri decided that, let me make a calf out of gold and I will tell the people to worship this calf. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions this and he says, فَأَخْرَجَ لَهُمْ عِجْلًا جَسَدًا لَهُ خُوَارٌ. So Samiri, he produced a calf for them that had a mooing sound.
فَقَالُوا هَذَا إِلَهُكُمْ وَإِلَهُ مُوسَى فَنَسِي.
So he said, this is your Rabb, this is your Lord, and the Lord of Musa, and he forgot. He forgot that this was his Lord, so he was calling you to the one who creates from nothing. So he began to deceive the people, and the people began to worship this calf. So when Musa alayhi salatu wasalam got back, he was very angry and he was sorrowful that these people had been called to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his worship. They worshipped him and then they went back to worshipping a calf made out of gold. Now if we take a look at this situation, then we will come to realize that Samiri had brought a calf that was made out of substance, something. And that substance in reality was created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one who placed the gold in the earth for them to dig it up. And he then took this and fashioned a calf in order to mislead the people with that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had created. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates from nothing. So if these people were to look at the calf and they were to think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they would naturally realize, or we would think that they would realize, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. Yet they worship the calf. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ يَا قَوْمِ إِنَّكُمْ ظَلَمْتُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ بِاتِّخَاذِكُمُ الْعِجْلِ.
Musa alayhi salatu wasalam told his people, O my people, you have oppressed yourselves by taking the calf as a god.
فَتُوبُوا إِلَى بَارِئِكُمْ.
So return and repent to your Rabb. Repent to the one who created you from nothing. He uses this word bari', which means he created from nothing. So he is the only one who deserves that worship. Al-Musawwir is the last stage of creation from the three stages of creation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions. And he says, هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور. The fashioner, the one who designs, the one who makes a human being into who he is by fashioning his nose the way it is, his mouth the way it is, his eyes. He splits open his face at a particular place in order for him to be able to see.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who fashioned all of that. So who are we then to go out in the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, he has a bulbous nose, he has bulging cheeks, she has very large ears. Who are you and who gave you the right to do that? Yet he is al-musawwir. He is the fashioner. You know what we are doing in reality when we go out there and say she is ugly, he is ugly? We are insulting the fashioner. We are insulting the designer. Who, he who made that particular creature. So let us get rid of this mentality. Let us get rid of this ideology. It is only from shaitan that he comes to us and teaches us how to do this evil and this bad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he despises it when a human being goes out there and tries to sculpt something similar to his creation that is animate. That is animate. So, if we sculpt a tree, for example, this is okay. If we sculpt a mountain, for example, this is fine. You sculpt and you paint a picture of a river, then this is okay. But the minute you begin to paint pictures of animate objects, human beings, the animals that are out there, then this is despised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because he is al-musawwir. He is the fashioner. And this is why on the day of Qiyamah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us that إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَصْنَعُونَ هَذِهِ الصُّورَ يُعَذَّبُونَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ ثُمَّ يُقَالُ لَهُمْ أَحْيُوا مَا خَلَقْتُمْ. Indeed, these people who sculpt these creatures or who paint these pictures, they will be punished on the day of Qiyamah. And it will be told to them, أَحْيُوا مَا خَلَقْتُمْ. Bring to life that which you have created. You felt you were the creator? You felt you were the fashioner and designer? So why don't you blow the life into that creature? Because you are not a god. Because you are not ilah. You are not al-khaliq. You are not al-bari, al-musawwir. So understand that. So these are some of the characteristics of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we move on to the name Al-Malik. Al-Malik. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes himself as Al-Malik. And we have the description of Al-Malik with us as well. And this means, we usually translate it to mean the king. But if we truly want to understand it, then this really means the one who possesses everything in existence and he does whatsoever he wishes, when he wishes, how he wishes, and there is no defense and no rejection of his command in any way whatsoever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his kingdom means three things. It means three things. Number one, the affirmation of his qualities such as the supreme power, complete control, ultimate capacity, the encompassing knowledge and the rule of the lower and the higher realms of the dunya and the akhirah. So this is the first stage of the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second stage is that all of creation are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regardless of whether those are the kings or those are the servants. They are all in dire need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now if we pause for a moment and we think about the kings of this world, or should we rather say the tyrants of this world, because you have Imamun Adil, a ruler who is just. But as for the tyrants of this world, you find that these tyrants think that they have authority. They have power. They have might. And whilst they are having these feelings within them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in complete control. Yet they do not realize. Yet they do not perceive. They do not fathom. The Pharaoh was a person who said at one stage, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى. I am your Rabb, the highest. Worship me. He called to his worship. He called to his worship. That was the height of arrogance. Yet what happened when the waves were closing down on him and the water was coming crashing down on him? Why could he not tell the waves, stop, wait where you are, I am your Rabb, the highest? Where did all of that power go? Where did all of that authority go? Where did all of that might go? It disappeared completely because he was not Rabb. He was not Rabb. And all of a sudden, آمَنْتُ بِرَبِّ مُوسَى وَهَارُونَ. I have believed in the Rabb of Musa and Harun. Why do you believe in this Rabb? Yet you yourself claimed you were Rabb. Because now he saw the unseen. He saw the reality. All along, he knew the reality. But he was so intoxicated with the power that he had that he ignored that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only being worthy of worship. And all of a sudden he believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but it is too late.
الآن وقد عصيت قبل وكنت من المفسدين.
Is it now that you are believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And you disobeyed before, you disbelieved before. And you were from those who were corrupt. So it was too late. The message is simple. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, no matter what position we hold, no matter what authority we hold, no matter what power we have, the ultimate power, the ultimate position, the ultimate authority is for Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. And when we understand this, then only truly we will be the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third and final stage of the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that all of the affairs belong to Him. He is the one who forgives the sins. He is the one who opens up hardship. He is the one who removes the sorrow. He is the one who cures the sick. He is the one who honors the dishonored. And He is the one who dishonors those who are honorable and high up in state. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ. Say, He is Allah, the owner of the dominion, the kingdom. تُؤْتِ الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ. You give kingdom to whomsoever you wish. وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءُ. And you snatch away kingdom from whomsoever you wish. وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ. And you honor whomsoever you wish. وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ. And you dishonor whomsoever you wish. بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ. In your hands is goodness. إِنَّكَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Indeed, you are able to do everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to do everything. Every day you find people calling out to Him, asking Him for something that they need, and there are billions of people across the globe. He attends to every single one of them. Yet that does not decrease Him in His might in any way. يَسْأَلُهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ كُلَّ يَوْمٍ هُوَ فِي شَأْنٍ. Those who are in the heavens, including the malaika, and those who are on earth, they ask Him all the time. He is engaged in some activity. كُلَّ يَوْمٍ هُوَ فِي شَأْنٍ. And that does not decrease Him in any way whatsoever. At the time of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, there was a king. And this king was known as Nimrod. Nimrod was a very tyrant king. He did not acknowledge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, he was similar to Fir'aun in that he said, I am your Rabb, so worship me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala discusses this. And He says, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِي حَاجَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ فِي رَبِّهِ أَنْ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْمُلْكِ. Do you not see the one who argued with Ibrahim that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regarding his Rabb, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given him the kingdom. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him kingdom for such a long time, he forgot and he disregarded the fact that he was the creator and not himself. So he began to argue with Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. Ana uhyi wa umit. I am the one who gives life and I am the one who gives death. So Ibrahim alayhi salatu was salam told him, Ibrahim alayhi salatu was salam told him that Allah is the one who gives life and Allah is the one who gives death. So this man was so ignorant that he brought a man who was destined for execution. And he said, kill off this man. So when the man was killed off, then he said, you see, I killed him off. And then he brought another man who was destined for execution and he said, I pardon this man. So let him go. So do you see, I am the one who creates life and I am the one who gives death. So Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam did not begin to argue with him that, hey, you know, your argument is useless because so on and so forth. But he clearly drew a line next to that which was misguided, a straight line. And he says, if you are the Rabb, if you are the creator, then bring the sun from the west because my Rabb brings the sun from the east. Bring the sun from the west because my Rabb brings the sun from the east. فَبُهِتَ الَّذِي كَفَرَ. So the one who had disbelieved Nimrod, he was completely destroyed by this argument of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. So ultimate kingdom, ultimate dominion belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On the day of Qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take the entire heavens and place them on a finger. Then he will place the earth on a finger. Then he will place the trees on a finger. Then he will place the rest of creation on a finger. ثُمَّ يَهُزُّهُنَّ وَيَقُولُ أَنَا الْمَلِكِ. Then he will shake them and he will say, I am the king. I am the king. This in reality is the creator. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heard this story from a Jewish man, ضَحِكَ رَسُولُ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smiled, tasdeeqan lima yaqul, showing that this is true what this man was saying. And then he recited the ayah, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. And they did not appreciate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his true appreciation. وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And the heavens will be in his grasp, all of them, or the earth will be in his grasp, all of it on the day of Qiyamah. وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ. And the heavens will be rolled up in his right hand. Subhana, glory be to him, exalted be he. وَتَعَالَى عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. From that which they associate partners with him. Understanding these names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should lead us to the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all of his glorious names and all of his exalted qualities to grant us the ability to worship him in the manner that he wants us to worship him. Ameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.